Today we're going to talk about power supply transient response. What is it? How is it measured? And why is it important? Power supply transient response, what is it? It's a characteristic which describes the power supply's response to a large change in output current. It's typically specified for a 50% change in full-scale output current, and it's specified in constant voltage mode with a resistive load. Transient response measurements of a real battery. Let's first consider a response to a load change for a battery. On the left here, we have an actual battery shown with its internal voltage and internal resistance. On the right, we have a load that can be switched from 1.2 ohms to 2.4 ohms. In the graph on the right here, we show that the switch starts in the open position, moves secondly to the closed position, and then returns back to the open position. The current in the circuit when the switch is open is going to be VL divided by 2R, and when the switch is closed is going to be VL divided by R. What you can see in the third graph is what happens when you switch from open to closed. The output voltage at the load, V load, starts out here. Then when you change to the higher current, that internal resistance causes an additional voltage drop, so the voltage at the load drops down to this level, which can be defined as V battery minus IL times R internal. And then when the switch is open, it returns to its original voltage over here. Now in the second case, let's consider a power supply. We have a power supply on the left here, which has very low output impedance, and we program it to a V out. We have the same setup on the right where you're switching in a resistor and then you're shorting it out. So we start out with the switch open, we go to the closed position and back to open. So it's the same conditions as for the battery. You have the current in the load is defined as V out over 2R when the switch is open, and V out divided by R when the switch is closed. What you'll notice in the third graph is that the output impedance of the power supply causes the V out to vary far less than for the battery. If you zoom in on that condition, though, there are some overshoots and undershoots, which we will discuss next. Let's talk about transient response specifications first. Power supplies, since they're active, have some overshoot and undershoot associated with them, since the loops don't have infinite bandwidth. We specify a power supply both for the time it takes to recover and the amplitude that it has to recover to within over here. So a typical spec for a power supply would be less than 100 microseconds to recover to within 50 millivolts for a load change of 50%. So we have the two boundaries here, the 50 millivolts and the 100 microseconds. So as long as the power supply is back within that limit before the end of the time is up, it's meeting its spec. There's other parts of the waveform that are not specified. Vpeak, undershoot, and overshoot are not specified. The reason these aren't specified is there's too many variables that can cause these voltages to go up and down. The load lead length, the dressing of the leads, whether they're twisted or not, and the load itself, whether it's reactive, can all affect Vpeak, overshoot, and undershoot. So you must be careful when attaching load leads that you're making them as short as possible and you're twisting them together to minimize the amount of inductance in the actual load leads. Transient response issues that can come up with a power supply that is poorly regulated or has poor transient response is that you can actually have an undershoot that goes below the low voltage shutdown of the circuit. A good example of this would be a digital cell phone. When it goes into talk mode, it draws a large amount of current and has a battery detect circuit, which once it goes below will shut off the phone in that condition. So this power supply, if it has bad transient performance, would be unacceptable for cell phone testing. The other problem you can run into with power supply transient response is it's too slow. The condition here shows that the power supply is still actually settling by the time you go to the next transient. This goes as a problem when you're actually trying to make fast measurements in a test system when you want to go from one condition to the next. If the power supply hasn't settled out yet, you can't make an accurate measurement. So slow transient response time can actually affect how long it takes you to run through your tests in a test system, which can cost you money. I hope this has outlined some of the issues that come up with and how to measure transient response in a power supply.